A horrific shooting. 11 Jewish Americans killed by a suspect in Pittsburgh who posted hate-filled messages online. The same day, President Trump offers this response to the tragedy.
If they had protection inside, the results would have been far better.
His response upset many who believed the president was blaming the victims. As the criticisms poured in, Trump turned on his favorite target, the media. The fake news media, the true enemy of the people, must stop the open and obvious hostility and report the news accurately and fairly. It's an example of the tribal atmosphere now consuming American politics. And according to one author, Trump didn't create the problem, but he is exploiting it.
Trump is not a healer. He never pretended to be a healer. He exploits the division of the country for his own benefit.
As the U.S. faces a midterm election next week that will determine control of Congress, Trump has refused to turn down his rhetoric at political rallies aimed at his opponents.
The Democrat Party has become too extreme to be trusted with power. Their radical policies are a danger to your family and to your country.
Schneider argues it's one of the main obstacles to getting anything done.
It creates ill will, bad feeling, of course, but it also means that we're in perpetual gridlock.
The White House disagrees the president's fiery language is a problem.
And I think that the president's the best messenger for the party. He's had an incredible, historic first 2 years in office, and he has a great story to tell.
But instead of voting for someone or something, Americans are now casting ballots based on loathing and anger towards the opposition. It's behavior that political scientists say will shape U.S. voting patterns well into the future. Kimberly Halkett, Al Jazeera, Washington.